Katie Rozelle is here. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you. I'm really excited.
So talk about, why did you focus on children and eating disorders?
So we did a literature search, and we found that this hadn't been looked at 9 and 10-year-olds at all, and we had the data available, so we wanted to see what the rates were.
So how did the study work? How many kids were researched? Boys, girls, everybody?
Yeah, so it was 4,500 9 to 10-year-olds, and it's nationally representative, so it represents what the U.S. actually looks like.
And of those children, 4,500, how many of them, what was the rate of eating disorders in boys? And I guess girls are, it's more common in girls, is that right?
So actually, we were surprised to find that in this study, the rates for eating disorders were the same for boys and girls.
The same?
Yeah. Yeah, and so typically around puberty is when you might see that girls will have increased risk for eating disorders, but at this age, at 9 or 10, we saw the same rates.
For boys. It's so interesting because you don't hear about boys, especially 9 and 10-year-old boys, with eating disorders. And it was about 1% of the population for each sex. Is that right?
Right. About, I think, 1.4%. So 52 out of the 4,500 that
we looked at. What did you hear? Like, did you interview these children? How did you uncover their eating disorders? And what is the takeaway here? What does this mean?
So this is part of the Adolescent Brain and Cognitive Development Study. It's a really huge $10 million study that's being done at a bunch of different sites around the country. So we used the data from them, the sample that they had of 4,500 kids, using the DSM-5 to determine if they met criteria for an eating disorder.
So why are kids developing eating disorders at such a young age? How does that work?
So we don't really know why they're developing them. A lot of times later on in life, we know that a lot of investment in one's physical appearance and, you know, fear of food, fear of gaining weight is something that leads to an eating disorder. So it could possibly be the same in this age group as well.
So for kids who develop eating disorders that young, is it something that they outgrow in young adulthood or hopefully before? Or are they more likely to battle it throughout their life?
Eating disorders are very difficult to treat, so I can't say for sure, but I would imagine that it's something that would stick with someone.
And when you're talking about eating disorders, we're talking about anorexia, where you actually starve yourself, and then there's bulimia, where you get sick and throw up.
Right, compensatory behaviors.
And there's purging, too, right? Mm-hmm. That you just eat a lot and then get rid of it.
Right, so we assessed anorexia, bulimia, and also binge eating disorder among these kids.
So what happens next, Katie? What are you going to research now?
So we'd like to further categorize the sample, so looking at race, ethnicity, socioeconomic status, and this is also a longitudinal study, so it'll last 10 years, so we can actually see how the rates change and how risk factors may change for boys and girls.
Because it really does affect the brain. I mean, the 9 and 10-year-olds, they're developing, and this eating disorder can really be a health hazard.
Yes, absolutely.
Well, it's good to see it's a priority. Thanks
so much
for sharing about it. Appreciate it.
Yeah, thank you for having me.
All right.